Good morning, everyone, and warm welcome for this third edition of Leadership Summit organized by Elets in Maharashtra. I am lucky to say, actually, the first edition was hosted by Government of Maharashtra here in Mumbai itself, and the third edition is also being supported by Government of Maharashtra. Dignitaries on the dais, my senior colleague, see Dr. Chahande sir, who is heading UID in Maharashtra. Other colleagues, Arjit Basu, Satish Pillai, Ashish Chauhan, my good friend from Bombay Stock Exchange, Ravi Guptaji, who is here hosting. I've attended his conferences in different parts of the country also. They are very well meticulously organizing these conferences, giving excellent results. We are happy to be associated with Elets in Mumbai. Other colleagues and participants and dignitaries here, I will not take much of a time. I am sure most of you would be looking forward to hearing the dignitaries and the dais who are going to speak on different subjects, including financial inclusion and technology developments in various sectors of financial world. Financial department is pleased to support this endeavor. Our objective here is to see how in Maharashtra, probably one of our attempts is to reach out to the unreached and last mile citizens through these technology, especially the financial inclusion, which is a major objective of the present government and present government in government of Maharashtra as well as in central government, in reaching out to hitherto left out and last mile villages in the hinterland of Maharashtra. I'm really heartened to see this excellent response. Our small efforts in the form of sending out to invites to various dignitaries in banking sector, regulators, and technology sector. I'm really happy to note that there is a good response, and Elets has organized it and coordinated with these invitees excellently. I'm really happy for the response. This conference is an attempt and an effort to bring out various stakeholders, especially the government officials, senior government officials who are in the financial sector, other stakeholders, regulators, the bankers, and the market regulators, so that we come on one platform and see what are various hurdles, various blocks we face, so that we remove these things and discuss and detail it out, and send a recommendation to Government of Maharashtra and to Government of India, so that we, in turn, when the policy, public policy is made to reach out to the public, to reach out to the common citizens, how excellently we can roll it out and seamlessly we can roll it out our policies, so that the very objective of reaching out to the people is excellently carried out and achieved. With these objectives, we have called various stakeholders. I'm sure today's conference and deliberations and discussions will go a long way in helping out in policy formulation and reaching out to people through these policy formulations, hitherto untouched part of the society. In fact, I'll not take much of your time. I know we are looking forward to the other dignitary speeches. I'll just end with one note. About financial inclusion and how this financial inclusion, how the technologies in banking sector has transformed the way we do banking, the way we conduct our financial transactions in the country, probably all over the world. All over the world has really gone ahead. The transactions they do online are in comparison with us are much ahead. In fact, in one of the data sets I was reading in the morning today, it says online spend by the Indian citizens when we do e-retailing is hardly $224 per person. whereas we compare it with other countries, especially the Western countries, USA or European countries, we stand nowhere near to their figures of online transactions. Most of the transactions they do in European countries and Western world is online transactions. Whereas in India, though we have started and technology is there, we are very initiators of this technology, developers of these technologies, but still the rollout in India is still lagging behind, and our citizens using using these online platforms for carrying out transactions, either retail transactions or any other transactions, is still slow and low. Wherein the technology partners has to come and see how we can roll it out faster, reach out to these faster and make it more customer friendly, so that people gain confidence and use these platforms, so that we gain our own strength in it. The same way I was reading, we have 390 million mobile users in the country, 390 million. Out of that, only 40% of the users perform online transactions. When we go for an online transactions, most of the transactions, most of the online visits doesn't transform themselves, doesn't transit themselves into a transaction per se. So here, though we have 390 million, only 40% of these visitors get transacted into a transaction. So these are various challenges. Though we have various infrastructures available in the form of teletechnologies or various platforms to reach out to the people, do transactions safely and securely, but still there is a set of apprehension reluctance on the part of citizens to use this technology in a safe way. Here I appeal to all these technology developers here present. This is where we need to focus and see how we can gain the confidence of users, so that the rollout is good and the government objectives in the form of reaching out to the people is reached out and smoothly attain that target. Digital payments, that's what digital payments was, what I was referring to in the form of financial inclusion. Even today in India, even in Maharashtra, we have large parts of the country and the state wherein the banking inclusion, either in the form of brick and mortar branches or in the form of mobile banking, is still not reached out. That's where I would like to appeal to all of you and our speakers to see how we can improve our technologies and reach out to the people. With these few words, I welcome you all, and I extend best wishes for this conference. And at the end of the conference and at the end of the deliberations, I'm sure Elets would give us an excellent report, so that we use these inputs when we formulate some public policies in the form of financial inclusion and inclusive growth. These would act as the tools for us to improve our performance. With these few words, I would like to thank Elets for inviting me here. Thank you very much.